Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about the solubility as well as the molar solubility, and now based on that we are going to talk about the solubility product of a particular substance. So let's talk about it. So the solubility product actually, which has been denoted by that is KSP, where SP stands for solubility product, and it has been defined as the product of the molar concentrations of the constituent ions of the electrolyte, each raised to the power of the stoichiometric coefficient in the equivalent, that is in the equilibrium reaction in the saturated solution at constant temperature. Because solubility is the one that we are considering at basically at a constant temperature, and that is what the solubility means, and that is what we are going to talk about the solubility product. But in this case, let us consider an electrolyte, and so based on that we could be able to define that is what is actually the solubility product. So for that, let us consider the electrolyte. So in this case, I have considered the electrolyte like AgCl, and as you know that AgCl is the salt, or we could also call it as the electrolyte, in which basically electricity can pass easily, but that is not very much soluble in water. So that's the reason it will dissociate completely to Ag plus as well as Cl minus. So therefore you could say that the equilibrium is being maintained, and only the small fraction of that is Ag plus would be obtained along with that of that is Cl minus, in which AgCl is basically of solid phase, while after dissociating it will become that is Ag plus along with that of the Cl minus ion, and for which we could easily make the, according to the law of mass action, we can easily calculate the equilibrium constant for this one, and that could be written as that is, and in this case basically I am considering like K, and it will be nothing but the ratio of the products, and in this case what I have got it as that is Ag plus along with that of that is Cl minus, and that is a concentration of AgCl. So in this case basically what they have mentioned is each raised to the power of the stoichiometric coefficient. So this is very much similar to that of the law of mass action that we have did, and based on that we have that is derived the expression for that is the equilibrium constant for the weak acid as well as equilibrium constant for the weak base also. So similarly it is very much same to that, and now I could say that is the solubility product, it is basically regarding the product of the ions that has been formed because of the electrolyte. So these are the products that are being formed from the electrolyte. So therefore what I can say is, if I multiply or if I arrange this one in this manner, that is AgCl, and I could write it in this way, that is Ag plus and that is Cl minus. So because AgCl is the one which is basically present in a that is in a solid phase, then I could say that this concentration of AgCl, which is basically present in a solid phase, will be itself a constant value. So therefore I could write this equation as like this one, that is K into K dash, which is equals to basically Ag plus, the concentration of Ag plus, that is basically the ions that has been after dissociation we have got over here, and this is what I have. So if I multiply this to that is a constant value, I'll itself get a constant value, but that constant value is nothing but the solubility product, because according to the definition itself it says that it is the that is it is the product of the that is concentrated molar concentrations of the constituent ions of the electrolyte, and this is what the constituent ions of the electrolyte, and that is what I could express for this example, and this is what the solubility product of the AgCl is. So similarly I can also write it for that is BaCl2. So suppose if I am talking about the electrolyte, like suppose BaCl2, so even on this it will dissociate into basically that is Ba2 plus along with that of 2Cl minus. So in this case the stoichiometric values of the product that I have got over here, as because I have used only one mole of BaCl2 and that has been dissociated into basically Ba2 plus along with that of 2 moles of Cl minus. So if I apply the law of mass action, or if I can calculate the solubility product easily or directly, and in this case it would be very much similar to give the solubility product for this one, that is it is nothing but the product of the concentration of the ions that has been dissociated. So the product of the concentration of the ions that has been dissociated, but meanwhile raised to the power of the stoichiometric coefficient. So therefore for Ba2 plus the stoichiometry is 1, so it is raised to 1. But for Cl minus, which is also a product, but the stoichiometer is basically 2, so this will be raised to 2. So this is how we can easily express the solubility product for a particular electrolyte. It was a very simple one. So that is friend, that is what I want to talk about, and this will be very much helpful in the next lecture. So I hope you have liked this video and you have got this video very clearly, and you share this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.